It's a meaty tiger prawn. You can see that in the size of the prawn. Each prawn weighs about 100 grams. This is a monster of a claw here. You can look at that meat that's there on this crab. My mouth is watering in anticipation of this piece of fish that I'm going to place in my mouth. And now for my favorite dish here at Karavali, the tiger prawn Malabar style. It's a meaty tiger prawn. You can see that in the size of the prawn. Each prawn weighs about 100 grams. So they're only about 10 prawns to a kilo. It's as precious as that. Prawn is first fried and then tossed in a masala that's made with shallots, some pepper, a little bit of tomato, and that lends its flavor to that prawn. You got that masala that's coating this prawn, and that masala gives it all that flavor. That masala is scrumptious. You can also taste the curry leaf that's gone into it. So we have the crab. That's a good sized crab, chef. This is a monster of a claw here. This is a monster of a claw. You can look at that meat that's there on this crab. This crab was what? Close to a kilo? 800 grams? How much was it?
Yeah, it's a kilo.
It's close to a kilo. That's how big this crab is. So for the crab, we decided to go with a tandoor crab.
Tandoori
crab.
It's nice sweet meat.
Oh, I love the sweetness of that crab. So what goes into a tandoori masala, chef?
Hankar, ginger garlic paste, red chili paste, then some mustard oil.
Kasuri methi powder. What I'm really tasting is the sweetness of that crab.
Sweetness of the crab meat.
This crab is as fresh as it gets. Yeah. Look at the quantity of meat in that crab claw right there. That's a crab that was well proportioned. That was a fat crab. There's chunks of meat there. There's chunks of crab meat. Chef, I thought when we ordered tandoori, I thought the crab will get overwhelmed by the tandoori marinade. But that's not the case.
No.
You're tasting the tandoori marinade. That's the first thing that you taste. But then...
But the crab meat...
The crab meat...
Means
still is itself.
Yeah.
Wow. You know, when you're eating crab, you got to go with both hands. Yeah. Well, there's no polite way of eating crab.
Oh, sorry.
Sure, when it comes to crab, no sorry required. What may happen is that your crab may land on my plate and I won't be sorry about that. Well, I just love this. I thought that with the bumble we hit nirvana, seafood nirvana. But this crab is something else altogether. I'm going to go for some of those tools now to
remove the crab meat.
To forage the crab. You don't want to lose any of that. So I find mud crabs are more flakier. They are the most solid in terms of the meat. Oh, they're more meatier.
More meaty. There's more meat and more flavor. Flavor is totally sweeter, right? It's a different flavor.
That's right. You have that sweet flavor of that crab. Oh, you want to get at all that crab meat.
Yeah.
You want to let that go. All that crab that's still remaining to be tasted. So I've just been served my Samudra Sadhya here at Hotel Ambika. I was told there were going to be 18 seafood delicacies on this Sadhya, but I've just counted and it turns out there are 19. So let's go through what we have here. So firstly, you begin with the pickles. You have two pickles here, and this pickle is made with the kingfish, or the ayakora as they call it in Malayalam. So this is a spicy kingfish pickle, and this is a kingfish pickle with some tamarind, with some puli. And then you have the a chutney which is made of dried shrimps. And then of course you also have a dried fish. I'm told this is called the Kuruchi fish locally. I don't know the English name. And then of course you have the Kundal Parishattu, the squid fry. Then we now moving towards what would typically be the other vegetables, but this is a pira that's made with prawn, those tiny shrimps. And then we have the avial. Where would a sandhya be without the avial? But the difference is that this is a seafood avial. So you've got, of course, the carrot that you recognize. I think this is some sort of a bean. But then you have the squid and you have other fish that find their way in this avial. And then you have a roast. This is a special roast that's made with the meat of the kaluma kaya. So this is the kaya minus the kalu. So this is the muscle meat roast. And then you have the pulushari that's made with clams. And you have to have the kappa. So I have a seafood kappa here. And this is, I think, a mix of some fish that's gone into this. I think there is some matti or some sardine that's gone into it. And then you have the nandu, the sea nandu roast. And we're not done. This is a curry that's made with some kingfish. I think it's a coconut based curry. And this is the mulagattu matti curry. I'm told this is a spicy curry. And then you have, of course, a sambar. Sambar that's made with fish. And then you have another curry here. And this is again made with the kingfish, the ayakora. I think that's a favorite fish here. And you have the papad as well. And I'm told this is a fish papad. So what you see here is basically the flesh of some fish that's been mashed into this avial, and that's really what you're tasting alongside the crunch of the vegetables. This is cooked perfectly. The muscles are yielding to the bite, and then you have that sweetness, that mildly spicy sweetness of the onions in this kaluma kaya roast. Oh, this is brilliant. The netoli and that ayakora, the kingfish. It definitely tastes a crunch of the bone as you bite into it. But the fish is softer than what I expected it to be. But it's tasty nonetheless, with that oil and that masala. Next, taste some of that kingfish fry, the ayakura fry. That's a generous piece of the kingfish. It's fleshy and it's naped in all that masala. You can see the flesh of the skin is white. It's as fresh as that. The kadalan nandu, the sea crab. The sea crab is naped in that masala, that roasted masala of onions and spices. So you have the sweetness of the onions, the sweetness of the crab, and then you have the heat of the pepper that takes over your palate. You can feel the heat of the pepper in your throat. I love this curry. I love the gentle tartness of that buttermilk or the moru in that curry. And the fish too has absorbed the flavor of that curry so beautifully. I'm to go for the fish masala curry. The stars here are one, this prawn golden fry as they call it. You know, this is a very traditional sort of a preparation. Prawn, it's crisp to the touch. There is no batter, no coating, just a little masala that is clinging onto the prawn. And I can tell you just by looking at this, that this is going to be delicious. Super. I can taste the sweetness of the prawn. I can taste the spice of the masala. The coating is just right. It is scrumptious. The prawn is cooked just right. There's also some curry leaf that you see that the prawn is cooked in the masala. Beautiful. The freshest possible prawn that you can ever taste. Having absorbed all the masalas, the kane fish fry was now ready, and I couldn't wait to dig into this fleshy, flavorful fish fry.
Hot, it's hot. You can taste the fish and you also taste the masala. The masala, despite having all those ingredients, despite having the chili, despite the tamarind and the lime, I think only works to coat the fish. But I can still taste the flavor of the fish.
know, the carne is a very delicate fish actually. It's not a fish which is very oily, it's not a fish which is very strong in flavor. And while the masala was being cooked, I was wondering whether the carne, the flavor of the fish will actually get overpowered by the masala. But I'm tasting it, I can taste the masala and I can also taste the fish. And I think they've come together beautifully well. Delicious.
So this is that important. So this is the masala that gets slathered on top of your fish. The kingfish. I think this is a much loved fish in this part of the country. Wherever you go, this is the fish that's on every menu, that's on every table. You got that masala that's slathered over the fish, and as it fries, that masala clings on to that fish in that thick, almost scrumptious sort of layer. And that's a thick slice of the fish as well. I can't wait to taste this. My mouth is watering in anticipation of this piece of fish that I'm going to place in my mouth. So you first taste the masala, you taste the heat of the masala, you taste the slightly salty tinge of that masala, and then you taste the flavor of the fish. And you also taste the flavor of that coconut oil. Get that fish, get that masala into that lentil curry and rice and make a mouthful of it. That rice helps tone down that slightly salty aggression of that fish masala. But prawns ghee roast. You see all this ghee here? When it comes to prawns, one is never enough. Let's taste just the masala first. Definitely taste the toasty notes of the coconut oil. That prawn is cooked just right. It's sweet, it's delicious. And it's got that beautiful ghee roast masala that's napping it. That masala doesn't overpower the flavor of the prawn a wee bit. So when you're tasting, you're first tasting that mild spicy heat of the masala, and then the sweetness of the prawn takes over. And these prawns are fresh. I'm going to taste these prawns also with some of that neer dosa now. The neer dosa and the prawn makes for the perfect combination. Neer dosa, because the batter of this dosa is runny like water, thereby making for an almost translucent sort of a dosa. This is a dosa that requires no fermentation. You grind the batter and it's ready to be used right then and there. I'm going to take this and get some of that ghee roast masala. You know, ghee roast masala has a mild sweetness to it, perhaps absorbing some of that from the prawn as it's cooked. Delicious. We'll taste some of that neer dosa now with that masala and with that prawn. I absolutely love this dish. Take some of the masala, take some of that oil and drop it on my plate. So even if you're done with the prawn, you still have that masala and you've got a neer dosa. A brilliant medium to mop up all those flavors. I think it's time to perk things up with this sear fish mango curry, or the Ayakora mango curry. This, I'm told, is again a very popular dish here at Paragon. This is a dish that's been on the menu for over 20 years. So I've got the fish. I also want some of that mango. So these are slivers of raw mango that is used to flavor this curry. I think I'm going to taste the fish first without the mango. That fish has imbibed the sourness of the raw mango, and I also tasted a sliver of the ginger. And you also have the ulli, the tiny onions, the shallots in this curry. That onion is not completely broken down by the curry, so it still has some bite intact. I'm going to go for this dish with some more of that appam. That soft, spongy center of the appam, because I think it's such a great bread to mop up that curry. The tart flavor notes of this mango curry here at Paragon. I think it's time now to try the fish with a sliver of the raw mango and also some curry leaf for good measure. You know, when you taste the raw mango, you're expecting to taste the sourness of the mango. But you taste just the slightest hint of the sourness because that raw mango has served its purpose in the curry by imbuing the fish with its starch.
And the white pomfrey kodi. They just dry it out and they bring that masala separate and they sprinkle some masala on the fish. I'm going to taste it without the masala first. The fish is fresh. You can see the pristine white of the pomfrey. The fish is beautifully seasoned. I can taste the salt all the way into the fish. I'm going to now taste the fish with the masala that they call. Basically, which are the pan trimmings after the fish has been fried. It's salty. So I think when they dry it out, the salt, I think the flavors get really concentrated. I personally would prefer just a bit of the masala, not too much of the masala on the fish. Otherwise, makes it a little too salty. The fish is absolutely fresh. Lovely.
I think next we're going to taste some kalmakaya fry. So this is not a dry fry, but it's a wet sort of a fry with some onions, with perhaps some tomatoes. I taste the sweet flavor of the fennel. There's some fennel that's gone into this kalmakaya fry. This kalmakaya is cooked to the perfect texture. It's firm yet yielding on the bite. And the fried onions lend it that delicious sweetness. And then you have the sweet acidity of the tomatoes or the takali. Oh, this is cooked beautifully. This is a delicious kalmakaya fry or the mussels fry. Think of the patri as an edible rag of sorts, which you can mop up all forms and textures of deliciousness off your plate. So whether it's a gravy, whether it's something in a semi-gravy like this mussels fry, the patri sure does a good job of mopping all those flavors and conveying them safely to your mouth. I should stop, as they say, you got to stop when the going is good. But this mussels, this kalmakaya definitely deserves a third serving on my plate. I can also now taste the heat of the green chili. It's a mellow, lingering sort of a heat. I think there's some ginger that's also gone into it. And it definitely asserts itself in the warmth that you feel beneath your tongue. If you'd like to support the work that we do at Food Lovers TV, do consider joining our membership community on YouTube by hitting the join button below or on the home page. You could pledge a nominal sum and receive special privileges like behind the scenes footage, shoot updates, access to live Q&As and a lot more. You could support us on a Patreon page as well. For more info, check out the links in the description below. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and leave a comment below. Happy eating!